Hi, I'm State Senator Ann Rivers from Washington's 18th Legislative District. We have 3 weeks left in the 2015 legislative session. We still have a lot of work to do, but I feel confident that we're going to finish up on time. This week, I expect my bill that harmonizes the medical cannabis and the recreational marijuana industry to move forward. When voters approved Initiative 502 in late 2012, they authorized an industry that would be tightly regulated, keep pot out of kids' hands, and provide revenue much the way that tobacco and alcohol already were. The problem is, this new recreational marijuana market is in direct conflict with the unregulated medical marijuana market approved by the voters in 1998. An industry that, quite frankly, operates more like something out of the Wild Wild West. Let me be clear, I did not support Initiative 502. However, late in the 2013 legislative session, almost 2 years ago to the day, I concluded that if any legislator was going to try and reconcile the conflicts between Washington's new recreational marijuana law and the state's long-established medical marijuana law and limit the damage, it would have to be me. Fast forward to today. After contentious public hearings, countless stakeholder meetings, and tours that have included dispensaries, grow operations, and collective gardens, my Cannabis Patient Protection Act easily passed the Senate in mid-February, and I'm hopeful it will become law soon. Some of the key elements are stopping the misuse of medical marijuana authorizations. Right now, anyone of any age, and regardless of whether they are a true patient or not, can get an authorization. My bill would get a handle on who the true patients are, give them a tax break on their purchase, and ensure that they're getting a safe product. My bill also transitions current dispensaries into licensed recreational shops with a medical endorsement. As someone who has seen people get relief from medical marijuana, I wanted to find a way to ensure access while addressing the legitimate concerns that had been raised. My Cannabis Patient Protection Act tames the Wild Wild West by putting up some much-needed fencing around the open range while respecting the spirit of both initiatives. My goals have remained the same for the past 2 years: for legitimate patients to have safe, clean, and adequate supply of their product, keep our children from accessing marijuana, and get rid of the black and gray market. Currently, someone as young as 14 can obtain a fraudulent authorization for about $200. They are then able to purchase 24 ounces of marijuana. Think a big black garbage bag full. They can break that down into smaller baggies and sell it to their friends and their friends and so on. The registry included in 5052 will stop this practice from happening, because we will be keeping track of the authorizers. My legislation will go a long way toward realizing what I believe the voters had in mind when they made these laws in the first place. As always, you are welcome to email me your thoughts, call my office, or visit me personally in Olympia. Take care and have a great day.